COP26. Now let's break this down. I'm sure you've heard the term being mentioned more frequently in the news, but what is it, where is it taking place, and most importantly, why? Now COP26 is the 26th meeting of the Conference of Parties, aka the United Nations Climate Change Conference. It will be the 26th year that global governments, NGOs, businesses, trade unions, and everyone else who's interested in climate change meets to review and negotiate global action. Hi Greta. This year's event takes place on November the 1st to the 12th in the city I'm currently based in, which is all the way in Glasgow, Scotland. World leaders will be heading to Glasgow for COP26, which is formally hosted under the UK presidency. But wait, there's more. The world will be watching as national leaders from around the world convene with a hope for international cooperation on climate change, focusing on solutions and how targets will be met to tackle the issue. So why does COP26 matter? In 2015, the world's nations made a commitment to contain global warming under the Paris Agreement. Now, the Paris Agreement is a legally binding international treaty on climate change, but the goal was to ensure that global warming would be limited to well below 2 Celsius. A timetable was agreed in Paris called an NDC, National Determined Contribution, which saw each country submit their plans to limit emissions. However, the most recent progress report in 2021 shows that of the 190 countries that submitted their NDC plans, it falls short of meeting the goals of the Paris Agreement. So what's at stake in this year's COP26 conference? Under the presidency of the United Kingdom, COP26 must be a turning point where countries must deliver on actions by national leaders for the betterment of people and the planet. Their three main priorities will be to keep global temperature down to 1.5 degrees Celsius through emission cuts and net zero commitments, increase international finance for adaptation to at least half the total spend on climate action, and meet existing commitments to provide $100 billion in international climate finance each year so that developing countries can invest in green tech and protect their livelihoods against the negative effects of climate impact. Now, I hope that you have a better understanding of what COP26 is all about. If you found this video useful, please hit the like button, share, and subscribe on the link below.